Hello, Pokemon players. I'm Stefan Ivanov. This is Channel Fireball, and today we are taking a look at Arceus Beedrill Inteleon, which is a deck which got second place in the huge regionals in Indianapolis. 2 weeks ago now. So this is the list that Isaiah Bredner used to get second place after getting first seed after Swiss rounds. A bunch of other people in his group. People you might know, such as Rahul Reddy, Sam Chen, Xander Perot, and so on. Also, John Eng also played this deck or something very close. I think some people didn't play the Manaphy and played Quick Shooting Inteleon instead, but apart from that, it's basically the same list. And so this is a deck that actually works, and it's pretty fun because you have a stage 2 which you Beedrill, which is here because, I mean, persisting is great. You can knock out any Pokemon with special energy. So against an opposing Arceus, V-Star, or against UV Max, you can take 2 or 3 prizes and remove your opponent's main Pokemon just with a 1 prizer, which is great. And to play Beedrill, since it's a single strike Pokemon, we can use single strike Mustard, which allows you to get the Beedrill from your deck directly as long as you have no cards in hand. So there's a small fun element of getting your hand to 0 cards in hand so that you can play the Mustard, which is reminiscent of decks such as Arceus Blastoise, which also were pretty fun to play and were also like very competitive, right? Arceus Blastoise won world, so you can't really make a deck better than this. That's basically the deck. So you can see there's no Moltres here because Beedrill is a weapon we have against against Mew. There is no Garen Zapdos V or Hoopa V against Urshifu, stuff like this. Instead, we have like Beedrill, the main addition, and then we have like it's an Arceus deck, so there's 4 Arceus, there's a Charizard Care, there is Rayhan to get energy, and so on and so on. You basically probably know the drill. You've probably seen an Inteleon deck, an Arceus Inteleon deck before in this format. So as you can see, no Path to the Peak, there's little disruption. Again, this deck relies really a lot on Beedrill to work. So it's effective if there are a lot of special energy in the format, and it's as effective if there are not. Like Mew lists, which play 2 psychic energy, are going to do better against this list, but they are pretty rare right now. Most lists play a bunch of special energy, so Beedrill is going to be effective. So yeah, without further ado, I'm going to play some games with this so you can see the deck in action if you haven't already seen it on stream, for example, or if you haven't already played it. As you can see, it's a pretty effective deck. I mean, it's again, it's Arceus with Inteleon. You can't really make that bad, whatever you add to it. Since we're talking about it, I mentioned that some people didn't play the Manaphy. I think it's probably better to keep Manaphy right now. I know that Urshifu didn't do as well 2 weeks ago as you might have expected after it dominated EUIC, but I think that as soon as people say, well, we don't need Manaphy anymore, Urshifu is not here, Urshifu will come back, and I think it's better to be prepared. And I think you should keep Dunsparce and Manaphy, but I acknowledge that it's sometimes you are looking for a space to add some new card that you really want in the deck. And that could be a cut. I don't know. I wouldn't recommend it, but that's just me. Anyway, for this video, I haven't touched at the list. It's the same, but if you want to try the deck by yourself, there is a link in the description of the video where you can click it. It will give you a list. You can import that list in TCGO and try out the deck by yourself. And we start with when first game. There's a lot of light at me. Whoop. We start with a game 1 where it looks like we go second, but we do have a double turbo energy in hand, so I think I'm going to start with Arceus. It's risky, but I think getting the turn 1 Trinity charge is pretty strong. And we are against a Mew deck. So we could actually get Beedrill out, now that I'm thinking about it. We definitely can play Ultra Ball, discard, say, Marnie and Dunsparce, or Marnie and the card we draw, if we want to play down the Dunsparce, and get Beedrill. So I think that's probably worth it. Even if they knock out Beedrill on turn 2, Then they're using a boss and they're knocking out a one prize Pokemon, so that's probably very good for us. So I think we're probably gonna go for this play, obviously. It depends exactly what they do. They have a pretty good start themselves with two battle VIP pass on turn one. That's always something they like to see. Alright, so this is not ideal. Yeah, this is really not ideal because now if the second Beedrill is prized, we are... Well, we can still play the Mustard if even if it's prized, but it's gonna be awkward. But I still think that's the right play because we have a great opening hand. So yeah, let's play money. We discard money and Beedrill because of the card we cannot play. And okay, looks like the second Beedrill is here, so that's great. I'm gonna get Arceus here because we have the double turbo, so we can attach energy to it. And then next turn, we can probably evolve it into a V-Star. Inchilling is here, we have Zigzagoon, even though that's not gonna be very useful. Also, we have the Rod, and we can have the other Mustard, so if we want to use Mustard again at some point, we will be able to do that. So yeah, as you can see, we will have to bench the Dunsparce, which ideally we would like not to do, because Dunsparce doesn't do anything in this matchup, but it just takes one spot on the bench. That's not a big deal, so we are fine with that. I'm going to get another Sobol. We have Incenses, so that's great. And I'm going to use Trinity Charge. Get some energy. So the question is, do we have Air Balloon? We do. So I'm gonna attach an energy here. This is so even if they knock us out, we can use Training Court to recover the energy and have basically get a guaranteed way to get an energy on Beedrill. So, I mean, I guess we would have a guaranteed way with Arceus V-Star anyway, but that works better. So Escape Rope is really welcome here because now I can just send the Dunsparce and sacrifice it. Even though they could go Psychic Leap, we're fine. Obviously, they also have a boss and they go for the boss on Beedrill. I mentioned that this was an option, but again, it's not really, I mean, we don't care that much, to be honest. Yeah, they take one prize and that's fine. Now the question is, can we get a knockout with Mustard? And I'm pretty sure the answer is yes. So what we're gonna do is Incense, we can get Arceus. Yeah, it's gonna be pretty easy to get a knockout here. And we do. Okay, I said it was gonna be pretty easy. It's not that easy actually, because we do need a rod, because we actually discarded something. So what we need to do, we're gonna need to use Starburst before the Mustard. I wanted to keep it for after, but we're gonna have to use it before. So we get the rod. We could also go for, like, this is not 100% safe because we have to use Starburst. There's a risk that we don't find energy. So it would be probably a bit wiser to like we could go just for our boss here and knock out Mew. Maybe that's the better play, but I want to like I'm a bit greedy. I'm gonna see if I can do something cool with this because I kind of want to get a turn to knock out on Mew with Beedrill. So we will Starburf, we get an Ultra Ball. This allows us to get rid of these two cards. We will probably get another RCSV star with it. And now the question is, what do we take? I think like we can actually guarantee we can just get the training courts. And worst case scenario, we just retreat both with both energy and we get the energy back. So I think this is the safest play is this. And here we are. We can still use get a bit drilled back. Yeah, it looks like we're gonna have to discard both of these cards, but that's fine. We can even get a big charm here just to just in case, there's a very, very little risk, but yeah. So we're allowed to discard both because we can discard the grass first and then the double turbo. This allows us to get an energy in a discard, and we get it back. Then we attach it, and I'm gonna attach a big charm here, just in case there's something really weird. It would be very hard for them to get a knockout, and even if they did, we would have Beedrill for the revenge knockout, so I think that was probably not necessary, but might as well, I guess. Like, the only risk when you make a play like this where you discard your energy to get other energy back, where you discard energy from Arceus, is if they knock out your Arceus with the energy, then suddenly you have nothing left. Well, we still have the Beedrill left, so that would. That's not true. We would still be fine, and I mean we're really ahead in prices. I think there's very it's very unlikely that we lose, but just in case. All right, there's not really much we need to do here. Again, we're pretty safe. I'm gonna attach a capture energy here, so we can get one more stubble. We have only one energy in the one basic energy, so I'm gonna play the Rayhan, just because there's not really anything I more need to do. Just to attach one more energy here. We have Ultra Ball, we can get Inteleon with that. I guess we can Palpat just to get, just if in case we want to get Mustard back, if we want to use Mustard again, I think that's still possible thanks to the Ultra Ball. So, yeah. I'm not gonna play here because honestly, the easiest way to win is just to boss something next turn. I'm gonna play the Choice Belt here, though, and Trinity Nova. Yeah, the energy surge is another way we can help get an energy on Beedrill after using Mustard. It was prized in this game, and obviously we still need a Dunspar Drizzle or something to you to find it, but it is an option. Interesting. That's a weird card. Like, you would usually want psychic energy, basic psychic energy, for multiple reasons. Including, like, the main one is that you can play Fog Crystal to get the energy. But yeah, anyway, we can. Now we're just gonna look for the boss to win the game. I think it's possible with this hand to just must start once again. Like, I think it's actually a possibility, but. Well, maybe. Well, we'll have to play the scope net, I don't know. Honestly, might as well just go for that knockout. We have the energy. Trinity Nova. So, yeah, Arceus against. Mew is often a very close matchup, and this variant it can still be depending on the Mew list, but I think you can see how much Beedrill can help you get ahead if the opponent if you can actually use it against the opponent, like if they actually use a Mew VMAX with a double turbo energy like they did, and you can really punish that very heavily thanks to Starbirth, thanks to Beedrill. All right, looks like we win the coin flip this time, so we will go first because we are an Arceus deck, so we really want to go first. And that's actually a pretty good hand. Again, we have a must start, and our opponent is not playing Mew, so Arceus is basically no danger. That's great. So we can attach this turn. We'll see what we do next turn. We can quick ball stuff away. I mean, we don't really need anything right now. I think we can keep the quick ball for next turn depending on what we draw. Like, for example, if we drew into Inteleon, we could quick ball or Adrizal, we could quick ball away that card to get another card, then play the Rod, play this to get a V-Star, play this to get anything, and then play the must start. So, yeah, I think we don't need anything. Obviously, that depends on what the opponent plays. Like, we played the Hubam Ultras I showcased last week. There's a world in which they go. Bird Keeper into Rowlet and Wind Shard this, which would be bad. But honestly, that's not very likely, and there's no way I should go for the for Mana Fee here. Like, that's far too early to know. So yeah, okay. So we see Fighting Energy, we see a Mew, so that's interesting. Could be Urshifu or something with Zapdos. Could be the Hoopa Mana Fee. Like, some decks do play. Some decks do play something like this. So I'm gonna quick ball. We are going for Arceus here because we want to attach energy. But the fact that we see a fighting energy worries me, so I think I'm gonna get Dunsparce as soon as possible. So, because otherwise we are at risk of Zapdos, Rayhan Zapdos play. Beedrill might not be very important in this matchup, but I have the opportunity to play it. Like, see, like it's my best draw supporter right now. We have Mestar, so might as well get Beedrill out. You can always take an easy knockout with its other attack, the one that deals 110 damage. That's definitely not bad. So, Drizzile. I think I'm gonna use Quick Ball. We could play Lovable, but we only have one left. And I'm not using this Inversion Incense anyway. So yeah, let's get Dunsparce for security. We can always play must start and choose not to get anything and still draw 5 cards, by the way, if we want, as long as our bench isn't full. But I don't know how important that is. We will obviously get this double turbo energy. Question is, what do we want to get? And I think maybe the answer is Inteleon. Just getting this for next turn. So we can play, like, if we need to Terrence Care, we can Terrence Care and so on. Or if we need to boss or whatever, so. Okay, energy search will let us get the grass energy left in the deck for Bedrill if we want to, which we probably want. Now let's see what Auburn does. With three Sobble in play, there's really a lot of things they can do. And again, if it's the Hoopa Moltres deck I mentioned, they could go for Roulette Windshard here and knock out Dunsparce, which would open the door to a Zapdos play. No, it might, even if it's that, it might not be the end of the world. Yeah, we might be seeing a boss. We could be seeing a boss on Drizzle actually here. Koopa has grass weakness, by the way, so we could use Bedrill to knock it out. Yeah, that's the annoying part. So, I think using Bedrill here is probably the best. And I think we're gonna go for a knockout on the bench. Because getting rid of this is too important. Unfortunately, we had to discard the rod early on, so there's no way to get back Dunsparce. That's pretty annoying. I could scoop up net the Inteleon now. I think I'm gonna do it. This is a habit I have from when I was playing Arceus Inteleon a lot. It's not always correct, but the overnet was in the deck, so that's fine. And we can Drizzle here to get something more while still getting the option of getting Inteleon again. We don't really need a tool here, so I'm just getting the level ball for another Drizzle if needed. And Jet Spear will knock it out. By removing the support Pokemon, we are we can actually make it harder for them to do things. Like, yes, we did get Verhoopa back on the bench so they can attack us again, but I think we're okay with this. They could go for our boss on Drizzle, and that's a reason why I wanted the deliverable, so we can get another Drizzle, even if they do. But we do have the lead in prices, and after a while, when Hoopa becomes kind of useless, so I think we have the lead, although it's not clear. Okay, interesting way to play Marnie. So this means we're not using a boss this turn, which is great for us. We are gonna need one of our training courts to get back that energy, because there's only 5 grass energy in the deck, and the last one is prized. There's no energy left in the deck here, so we are gonna need something like this. Also, why are they? Oh, they actually got use Mew first. Yeah, I'm used to I have this this habit from, you know, the Jirashi era of the game, let's say, where when you use Jirashi, it would get to sleep, so you would have a visual signifier, but still, I wish had been used. Jirashi would be asleep here, but obviously Mew and the other Pokemon we've seen recently, like the Manaphy and the Celebi and so on, they don't do that. They don't get asleep, so they will stay here. But yeah, Mew did use its ability. It got the evolution incense. So, all right, so we see the Moltres. This is a bit early. If they have a Zigzagoon, I guess they can one shot this Beedrill, but or they could just deal 120 and count on quick shooting next turn to knock it out. Also, I think I took training court, right? So are they relying on training court to, yeah, that's good. So that's saves us the trouble of having to find the training court. That's great. All right. So we have an easy knockout here. I think I would like to find Big Charm and play it on Beedrill, just so they cannot knock it out with just a Zigzagoon or a quick shooting ping. So let's play the Herbaloon, I guess, here. And, well, it seems like a waste to use Marnie now, but we know they have Inteleon in hand, so it's not like their hand is dead at all. So we could get Inteleon. I don't. We have the Big Charm here. Do we need anything else apart from this Big Charm? I'm getting Inteleon because if I just get Dunsparce, I have no follow-up. Whereas here I can, you know, get a Drizzle for next turn if I want to. And again, grass weakness means that we can get this knockout. So I'm not gonna play the Palpite here because we don't really need that. We can play it next turn when we get something we want. If they go for, I mean, I would be surprised if they had a second Marnie, to be honest. Even if they do, that's fine, right? They Marnie, they knock out this. We are ahead by quite a bit. One other option that we have, and that is another reason why I got Inteleon, is that we also have the option to use Rayhan and to attack with Inteleon. So if they use Hoopa, for example, to take this knockout, something we can do is bring up Arceus, retreat to discard the water, Rayhan the water onto Inteleon, get the grass energy, and use Aqua Bullet to knock out. This allows us to keep attacking with a one prize Pokemon. And this makes it very hard for them because if they want to use Zapdos to use the fact that we don't have that we don't have Dunsparce, so that we have a fighting weakness, they need to play Rayhan at the same time unless they're playing something like Energy Switch. But if they don't, then they have to play Rayhan because they need two energy on Zapdos, and then they cannot play boss. And if they play Zapdos without the boss, then we can boss Zapdos and knock it out before it can attack. So that's not great for them. So yeah, here as you can see, even though the opponent doesn't play any special energy, Beedrill is actually pretty good. it works pretty well here. So opponent went for I'm not convinced by the order of operations here. I think using Mew first, then Palpite, then Inteleon was better, but whatever, I guess. So I could do what I said. I can also just keep using Beedrill here, which seems better, right? Training Corticeal in play. I feel like I could go for a boss here on Drizzile just to limit their options. I mean, I guess they can, because they need to take four prizes. Yeah, I think I like that, even though we. We can shut down all their lines of attack, but I feel like this boss is pretty good because, again, Hoopa is not really a threat. It's not going to knock out the Arceus, which is the main thing that worries me, but Inteleon can make it harder, easier for them to do that. So let's go for this Drizzile. We never bench this. This would be a mistake. I could play the Palpad now to get back boss, honestly. It's not a terrible play. I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna get maybe boss and Marnie. I don't think we need two boss here. And Marnie is also a very good tool against this kind of deck, especially once you start getting rid of their Sobble and Drizzile. Because basically all we have to do here is, you know, take one prize per turn. That's all we can do, but it's also pretty easy to do. So what we need to do is do that in a way where it's very hard for them to catch up to the prize in the prize trade. So for example here, unless we play Energy Switch, which would be a bad surprise, although I guess now we probably win even if we have Energy Switch, but yeah, for example, they need to take Either they can take this without attacking, with something like quick shooting and double zigzagoon or something, or they need to take to knock out Arceus and Arceus. And that's very, very hard to do, right? Because even Moltres only deals 220 damage, so even with a choice belt, it's not enough. So yeah, we have to play stuff like the Rod to get back. Sobble, they might actually play Sonya to get back. Yeah, they're setting up their board once again, basically, but that's pretty slow, like. That's not really what they should be doing this turn. I mean, I don't think they have an option, but yeah, as you can see, Bidwill took a lot of prizes, and now they need to take 3 prizes, and we need to take 2, and I mean, it seems like I think things are fine now. Just in case, I guess we get the Sobble because we want, like, in case weird things happen. And we have this right hand, which I guess we might as well play, right? Unless we need for something next turn. Gonna attach this here because I might take the scoop up net so I can get either Inteleon or Drizzle back and get something like a boss. I think that's probably the best thing we can do. We don't really need to play this, so yeah, Trinity Nova will take the knockout. And now, unless they have a very special Medicham play to Yogg-Gaanth Blessa Ball, which could, it's technically, no, it's so unlikely, like, they would need quick shooting, they would need zigzagoon and scoop up net, and they wouldn't have space for the Medicham because of, we don't have any more scoop up net. So yeah, not sure what we're doing here. Okay. All right, so I guess they discard. Yeah, so this was a play that was always a possibility, right? The Zapdos, Zapdos play, and with Keep Up Toughness, we don't actually. Well, actually, we have. Unless Zigzagoon is prized, we still have the. We can still do this with Choice Belt and double Zigzagoon. We could get a knockout, but. Like, we are just gonna boss and take a prize somewhere else. So yeah, Zapdos also was a threat, but thanks to Bidwill, we managed to play around it for as long as we could. And now, yeah, okay, I guess Zigzagoon play doesn't exist because Zigzagoon is the last prize, but we did put a boss back in the deck, so now we can get the boss. Yeah, pretty close game in the end. As you can see, if you misplay, if you don't plan ahead around what the opponent can do, you can definitely lose a game like this. And let's go for the next game. Looks like a mulligan. Looks like print mulligans too. So what did they go? Okay, Houndoom, Path to the Peak. I'm gonna assume Gengar. Very interesting matchup because Beedrill is not like the goal or anything, but Beedrill should be very good against Gengar, right? Because I mean, Beedrill just like Gengar plays a lot of special energy, so Beedrill can one-shot it. That said, the hand we have right now, not my favorite hand in the world. So I think, I mean, we could just get a Sobble and then keep the level ball for Drizzt next turn, but that would be pretty slow. So I think, especially since we have double turbo, I think the correct place to go Arceus here. Because they could play Marnie, they could play plenty of things. I think it would be weird to not get Arceus here. And worst scenario, we knock out a Houndoom on turn two or something like this. Like there are plays we can make. So yeah, not the best hand. Also, we have a battle VIP pass turn one, so that is good. Like that is honestly good for them, and as expected, it is Gengar. So we have, even if they don't Marnie, we have plenty of good top decks here. Any, well, not Quick Ball, but Level Ball, Evolution Instant, Ultra Ball are all great top decks. Obviously, any supporter, even Mustard is we can play Mustard here. Perfect. I mean, that's absolutely fine. So I think we Scoop Net, we Ultra Ball these two, we get Arceus V-Star, and then we Starbuff for another Arceus, and Mustard. The reason I get Ultra Ball here is that it allows me to discard Manaphy, which is going to be useless in this matchup. We do have a Dunsparce, which would be nice to get. So yeah, I'm gonna play Beedrill. I'm gonna want Dunsparce on my bench, so I don't really want to play Manaphy again. So I think something like this makes sense. We could get a grass energy first, but I don't think there's any need for that. So yeah, Arceus and Mustard. I think Arceus is more important because, well, it's not that easy. Well, he can get the knockout with two. He's gonna need two Houndoom though, and an energy. So I don't think that's that important. So yeah, I think getting another Arceus is gonna be better. And we have don't sparse here anyway. So yeah, I think using don't sparse here is good because it means they have no way to get the knockout with Sojourner. That means that they have to use Gengar, and then we can use Beedrill to punish that. It looks like once again energy search is prized. But whatever, we'll find another way to attach grass energy here. I just wanted to check. Okay, looks like I might have made a mistake because Inteleon is not in the deck. So keeping the Ultra Ball might have been wrong. Maybe I should have Ultra Bolt for the... for a sub ball, but we'll see. Yeah, having Inteleon prize is a bit annoying here, because no easy knockout. And looks like we will have the GMAX level swallow up knockout. But what we can do is, we can actually just go for a knockout on Crobat, take two prizes, and if they knock out, yeah, they can't. Okay, that's actually very good for us. I should have used that maybe to discard Grass Energy. Okay, looks like the Overmast Start is not... Oh, it's stupid. It's in the hand. Whoops. So we could Must Start this turn. But... I think we just take two prizes here, right? We can attach one energy somewhere. It will be discarded at some point. Or do we just attach this? Okay, this is actually pretty bad. pretty bad. It's fine, just not the ideal hand. Because we have too many cards that are not playable here, so in order to use Mustard, we are gonna need to play an energy before playing Mustard, which means that we cannot use it and put Beedrill active and just start taking knockouts. But again, it's fine. Even the threat of Beedrill was already big enough. It forced the opponent to, well, that and the fact that we might only have one energy, two energy, but like they had to go for Beedrill, and now we are ahead in prizes. So we can attack the Gengar, threaten it. Yeah, if Inthilon was in the deck, this would just be game over, but it isn't, so we will do what we can. That's not a great draw. I think we have to go for my start anyway, so I think the plan here is capture energy here, we get Sobo. Yeah, very annoying because we need to play this Arceus, so that means we cannot play another Sobo. That was a pretty bad draw. Well, we could also get a Sobo and not get the Vigil, but I think getting the Vigil here is just very good. But a lot of pressure on the opponent. We already attached, so I'm gonna keep the training court. But I'm gonna attach an air balloon here. Now I guess the threat is they retreat, they evolve this, earn, and they could go for Marnie. Which would be annoying, but again, they only have one path gone, so I don't feel comfortable playing training court because we all have already used an energy, so I'm gonna attack here. We still have a double trouble, right? So yeah, I think putting the energy here is correct. Also, the energy search is still prized, so there's no point keeping the energy there. We will not be able to get it reliably. Putting the energy here, even though we don't have an Arceus left, this has 100 HP, so even if they Marnie us, there's a world in which we can withdraw into the double turbo and a Drizzle, and we can go Drizzle boss and go and knock this out. This is our target. Basically, this is what we need to knock out this turn. Next turn, I mean. We have it, thanks to Beedrill. As long as they don't play Marnie. If they do play Marnie, then I guess we'll see what we draw. We also still need, you know, to... Well, I guess they have everything, right? But yeah, here's the path to the peak, which they could have played. Well, unless they don't evolve here. Okay, I guess they don't evolve because they're scared. Like, yeah, that makes sense, right? They're probably very scared of the of Beedrill, because if they evolve this, we don't even need a boss. We can just, an energy, and we can knock out this Pokemon with Beedrill. So they would need a boss this turn themselves to take one or two prizes, and then another prize after that, unless they go for the sleep. Okay, if we go to sleep, we have Charon, which we can use to heal. Yeah, that's not good. They go for the 4 energy. I guess they need the choice belt as well, because this deals 270 right now. By the way, there was no need to put the 4th energy here, except I guess to... Oh, they do have the choice belts. And the path to the peak. Yeah, well, actually that doesn't matter that much, but... Alright, that's not... Yeah, that's not great. Good news, I guess, is... They did use 3 urns, so they need the 4th one, but... Yeah, what's this there's no real point, I think. Yeah, I think we have to go for this. No DTE, so we're gonna have to use the training court and get the knockout with Beedrill. I don't see. Yeah, we know, or with Intellion, we don't have Intellion, so. we can Drizzile, but if they have the urn, they have the urn, they have the knockout. We can Drizzile, but we can never, like, if they have energy and boss, they win. There's no way we can protect ourselves against that. Yeah, I don't think we can do much more than just a persisting knockout. All trouble here for Arceus doesn't make cannot doesn't work because we don't have any Arceus left. Oh, I guess Rod wasn't played, so I guess we could have used Drizzle for Rod and Ultra Ball for Arceus V-Star. I don't think it changes anything, honestly. So yeah, now we only have one V, so Fear and Panic deals 60 damage. So if they have the boss, yeah, they have the boss. Okay. Oh, that's too bad. But yeah, there's no way to protect. I guess if we don't play this Sobble this turn, yeah, I guess maybe if I didn't play the Sobble, I could have evolved the Drizzile and gotten a big charm and attached a big charm to Dunsparce, and they don't have a target. So actually, I think I could have played around it. That was just my mistake. Yeah. Obviously, if they have the urn, they still win, but if they don't have the urn, if they just have the boss, I think Big Charm was still in the deck, if I'm not mistaken. So I could have played around it. It meant that I didn't have another Sobble for afterwards, but yeah, I think that was the correct play. So yeah, sometimes sometimes benching Sobble is not always correct. I should have thought a little bit more about my options here. I should have realized that my opponent's damage output was like there was a decent chance that it was going to be limited to 60 damage, and I should have played around that on that turn. So yeah, that's on me. But I mean, you play, you learn, you lose, you learn. That's the way you get better at this game. So I recognize, I think it's important to recognize your mistakes when you make them, even if they're not always obvious, but it's always good to think back to what you could do differently. So yeah, I mean, sorry about that last turn, which was played poorly by me. But hopefully you can see that the deck works pretty well, and it's pretty fun to just, throw it on your hand and just empty it so you can attack with a bigger with Beedrill and take a bigger knockout. We didn't actually get to use Beedrill to knock out against Garvimax this game, but it was definitely a threat that you wouldn't had to play around. Anyway, thank you very much for watching this video, and I will see you next week. And if you watch this before this weekend's regionals and you are participating in Lille or Perth or which one is it? Is it Secaucus or something? I don't know the name of the regionals in the US, but that one. Good luck to you, and yeah, hope you do well. Goodbye.